The second problem I have with the GLC is its procedures. The procedures are opaque. Nobody knows what is going on there. They just issue administrative fiats. I'm recommending that not just the GLC, but all the administrative bodies follow some process that includes issuing an exposure draft. This is what we want to do, and here's what we are going to do it. Circulating the exposure draft for people to give comment, holding public hearings, and publicly voting so that we can see that on this matter of introducing interviews, 7 members of the committee voted for it and 8 members voted against it. Right now, you don't see anything. We don't know if it is just the Chief Justice giving some fiats or is 2 people from the... Nobody knows. That is not how an administrative body is supposed to run. Here, it's not just the GLC, it's the country as a whole. Because as far as I know, the country does not have an Administrative Procedure Act. That is a very, very big problem in a country that takes constitutionalism seriously. And then the last point is that, in my mind, the GLC has no credibility because of all the problems that we've talked about. The comparative advantage of law faculties, we all know that. I'm not going to spend time on that. The core problem is, how do you fit so many students in the one law school that was created in 1960? When the School of Law was created, there was just University of Ghana. Now there are about 11 faculties, and we are trying to fit the products of all the 11 faculties in that one School of Law. That is the main problem. How do you solve this problem? Well, a couple of ways. One, I'm calling for the abolition of the General Legal Council, and I want it to be succeeded by a body that I call the Council for Legal Education and Practice. This is who I think should be on the council. It will not include the Chief Justice or any Supreme Court member, but the Supreme Court will nominate people to the council. And I want the council to focus on the following. First, licensing, monitoring, and accrediting law faculties. Second, determine facility and technology requirements for the law faculties. Third, determine the core curricula that students need before they can be enrolled to the bar, and then the requirements for admissions to the bar, and administering a bar examination. So in this model, all the education that you need is done at the faculties. And when you are done, you simply apply to take a bar examination, and if you are successful, you are called.